yeah, so I think the biggest question when people or when sellers get on selling on Amazon is how to improve the sales, right? That's the first question that comes into mind. And Amazon is, I think, like how Yael just mentioned, it is a big beast, right? And it comes in terms of running the business also on Amazon. So it's not just about having your listings and getting the right product, identifying the right product to sell on Amazon, but it also, there's a lot of effort and there's a lot of points that you need to keep in mind when you're selling on Amazon, including how to advertise on Amazon. And that is what I shall be talking a little bit today, or which is the Amazon PPC. So, well, I've already introduced by myself. I'm Nitin. I head the customer success team here at SellerLab. I'm helping all the sellers in the customer in the journey selling on Amazon. So briefly, SellerLab is a data analytics platform. We provide a lot of services, and we deal with a lot of intensive data, right? And it's not just about data, but it's about giving you meaningful insights, which can then be driven into and which can then be acted upon to increase your return on investment when selling. So we provide multiple services in terms of the platform itself, which has multiple features. It's got a lot of insightful data that comes out from there. You can use it to ease your optimizations. It could be optimization of the listing. You could use it to ease the optimization of your campaigns, and for a lot of research in terms of your product or identifying the right keywords to incorporate into the PPC campaigns or the listing itself. So what is Amazon PPC? So Amazon PPC is the advertising module, or it's an advertising system of sorts, which will help sellers position their products on the search pages for consumers to look when they're searching on Amazon, right? So it is a feature that will help you to put your product right at the top when because you have a lot of you have to compete against millions of customers and millions of products and sellers when selling on Amazon. So Amazon advertising gives you an opportunity to position your product right at the top when consumers are searching for these for the products. Now, why is it important? Because end of the day, sales is important, right? Everybody is selling product to make money. So Amazon PPC helps give you that edge, a little bit of an edge when you're selling, right? It gives you that visibility. It increases the visibility of your product. It increases the brand awareness, and it helps you maintain the top slot when you're searching on Amazon. Everybody knows that the attention span of customers, or the attention span on the e-commerce platform or anywhere online, is very less. Me personally, when I'm searching on Amazon or when I'm searching on Google itself or anywhere online, I wouldn't be spending too much time going on different pages. I'd rather change the way I search, right? So Amazon PPC gives us an opportunity to target multiple keywords, multiple products for which we want our products to be visible when consumers are searching for products. Let's say you're searching for a water bottle, and or let's say you're selling a water bottle, and when a consumer searches for water bottle, ideally you would want your product to be right there on the top, right? Because you don't want consumers browsing through pages. You want it right there on the top of the page where consumers can immediately interact with your product, interact with your brand, and then convert, hopefully convert, and then improve your sales. Now, Amazon has three different types of ads that you can run, right? They call it the sponsored product, sponsored brand, and sponsored display ads. So these are basically categorization of ads, and it gives you access to advertising a product in different areas and different avenues on the Amazon website itself. And just a side note is the sponsored brand and display campaigns are something that is available for brand registered sellers only. So it is also a very good idea for sellers out there to consider having their brand registered on Amazon, because we've seen a lot of engagement happening through sponsored brand and display ads. We've seen the conversions be a lot higher than running sponsored product ads. But then sponsored product ads is also very important, because that is the base of it. That is the base of running advertisements on Amazon. So what are these sponsored different types of advertisements? So sponsored product advertising is the one that comes on your search page of Amazon. So when a customer searches for a product, the first four search results are the sponsored product ads. Now, this is an excellent way to boost your sales for existing product. It helps you get more visibility of your products and is ideal to get your inventory running quickly. Now, sponsored brand ads helps increase the brand awareness. It improves the brand visibility of the product. So when someone searches on Amazon, brand ads, otherwise called as the headline ads, come right at the top of the search page. It gives you interact. So it also increases the engagement of the customers with your brand. So you can connect, or you can set up the entire sponsored brand in such a way that it can connect your storefront, thereby increasing the visibility for the products that are not advertised as well. It is great in improving the conversion rate, because not necessarily a customer might fall on to the product that they're looking for, but you might be having that product in your catalog. So it makes a lot of sense to have these brand ads running, which will help improve the engagement with your storefront, where consumers can see all the products that are being that are being presented on the storefront, which usually would cover most of your products, which therefore will open up the opportunity of consumers finding the product within your brand itself. And it also is a great idea to run these ads, because for seasonal products, it improves the visibility for those seasonal products, and you can customize and design sponsored brand ads for targeting those seasonal products as well. Another new feature that has recently come up a couple of months back, in fact, it's been close to 6-7 months, almost a year, I think, where Amazon has launched video ads in the, in the US marketplace, and they're slowly, launching it in the other marketplaces as well. And we've seen a tremendous increase in engagement with the product, as well as conversions through the sponsored video ads. So that's something to look out for when you're running these campaigns on Amazon. Then you have the sponsored display advertising. So this is a brilliant way to try and divert the attention of a consumer from your competitor's listing page, right? So these are ads that come right under the bullet points of your consumers or of your products. So targeting the right set of products from your competitor's space, or from your competitor product, helps move the targets or helps divert the audience from that product, from your competitor's product page to your own product page. So it increases the, again, the awareness of your product within the category itself. So there are ways you can set up these display campaigns where you can either focus on setting up or focusing on target audience within a specific category or a specific type of product itself. So these kind of all these different types of advertising modules gives you an edge and control on different types of control when running campaigns. So a product sponsored product helps you target specific keywords and products that you want to advertise your product for. The brand and the display campaign helps build the brand awareness and divert attention from your competitors to your listing page. Now, when you're running these campaigns, there are a lot of metrics that you need to keep in mind. One of the most important and the key metric that usually defines the performance of the campaigns is the advertising cost of sales. It is nothing but the ratio between the advertising spend by your advertising revenue. So obviously, the lower the ACoS, as we call it in short, the better your campaigns are performing. But we need to always keep in mind that not necessarily that a low ACoS is the goal to achieve, right? Because at different stages of running your business, you might have different goals. Let's say you're launching a product on Amazon. Not necessarily low ACoS would be your focus. You should probably focus more on increasing visibility and engagement with your product, which might come at a higher advertising cost of sales. So depending on what you want to achieve and what is your goal and what is your immediate agenda for selling the product, you should set up these and you should calculate the profitability and the target ACoS when running the campaigns. Now, it's also so this is another thing I'd like to slightly dwell upon. So I might be rushing through a couple of points over here, but if you have any questions that you would like to have a little more in-depth understanding of these, you could always reach out to us, and we can have one of our product specialists giving you a detailed presentation of detailed explanation of how to structure your campaigns or how to run campaigns, right? So structuring your campaign is very important on Amazon, because it gives you better control on how and where you spend money. Because end of the day, every click that a customer clicks on your product, you're being charged for it. So you should really be careful when structuring the campaigns, and structure them in such a way where you do not spend money on those unnecessary clicks, unnecessary irrelevant keywords for which you do not want to be advertised. So structuring the campaigns based on your keywords, on your product, your brand, your budget, or the geography helps you control where you're spending your money through advertisements. So you could If you need more information on this, you could reach out to us and we can help you out with the structuring of the campaigns as well. Another key feature that we have recently launched on our platform is to help a lot of our sellers through automation features. So Seller have recently launched this automation feature, which gives our users better control on optimizing their campaigns. Everybody knows that it is quite a mammoth task when you have multiple campaigns and you need to optimize them on a regular basis, or most definitely, not necessarily on a daily basis, but at least once every 2 days, you need to look at the campaigns, understand what are the key metrics that is impacting the campaign. So depending on the size of the campaign, you might have to look at it daily or every alternate day and take necessary actions in terms of marking few keywords negative or marking keywords that are not really performing well for us. So automation feature and our platform on Seller App gives you gives you control on certain rules that you can set up, or certain boundary conditions that we call it, which will then help take care of the regular day-to-day optimization activities that you do on your PPC campaign. It is a beautiful tool because it still gives you control on what needs to be optimized. It gives you control on how you want the automation to run for you, depending on what you have, depending on the agenda or the goal that has been set for a particular campaign. So it gives a lot of control at a campaign level on what needs to be done. And you don't have to necessarily run automation at an account level. As you could, you may not, but it's up to you. The whole control is given to you. You can set it up the way you want it. So that is about PPC automation, right? So so if you have any other questions in terms of running PPC campaigns, you could always reach out to us. You can drop an email to support@sellerapp.com, and one of our product specialists will reach out to you and address your concerns. And it doesn't necessarily have to be with just PPC. Like I've mentioned earlier in the presentation that we started off, we here at SellerApp are creating an ecosystem. So if you have any questions, any doubts, if you can just reach out to us, we will definitely help you out and at least reach out to the right set of people who would help you with whatever issue you have with Amazon selling.